Ladylike.
We're ladies, we swear. I know you can't say it, but it's okay.
It's fine, though.
It's fine.
E a gente vai conversar um pouco sobre essa história do Paul Show. A gente tá lindas e maravilhosas, assim. Fancy dressing. Because hoje é a festa de abertura do Paul Show e por isso a gente tá aqui. E por isso ela tá aqui, a gente vai conversar um pouquinho. Vamos pro inglês. Thank you very much for being here.
You're welcome.
I'm so happy to have you here in your channel.
Thank you. No problem. It's been amazing to come to Brazil.
Is it really your first time here?
It's my first time and I love it. I'll be back for sure.
Really? Mm-hmm. I was supposed to bring you a drink, but I thought that they wouldn't let me in with the drink. So I was like,
what drink?
It's like a Brazilian drink. It's called cachaça, but it has something on it. It's not like pure cachaça.
What kind?
Yeah, it's from the Amazon. It's something that...
Jumbo. I've had this.
it's so terrible.
It's so bad. But then it feels good. With the first sip, it's like, what was this?
I'm pretty sure you had... Jambu with the pinup girls, wasn't it?
Yes, absolutely. Yeah. And bar de cachaça in the Lamba. Of course, of course.
With the pinup girls. Woo-hoo. Girls, don't do this.
Actually, no, it was with Vitor.
It's like pretty much the same.
Actually, he gave me permission to include him in the girls, so
yeah,
it's perfect.
So it's perfect.
So,
yes. And I want to know, like, you're in Brazil, it's the first time we're doing Paul Show here, and it's gonna be a big event, we're very happy with it. And I want to know the story behind it, like...
How Paul Show started.
Yeah, who is Leanne and what is Paul Show, you know?
Well, so Paul Show is... Paul Show LA, it's a very different kind of performance show for pole dancing, and my goal with the show is to bring pole dancing as entertainment to the masses, to all the people. For now, pole dancing is attended by pole dancers, right? Or their friends, or maybe someone that hears about it. But I really want pole dancing to be recognized as an entertainment for everybody, just like circus or football. Not everyone that watches football plays football. And I want pole dancing to be like this. So Paul Show LA is my attempt to change people's perspective and make it a real show that is about the audience experience as opposed to the performer's experience. Most pole dancing events are about the performer's experience. They get to go on stage, they get to do what they want, their idea, their style. And Paul Show LA, I designed the show to be for the audience enjoyment. And sometimes the pole dancers don't like this as much, but it's a really good show. So in Paul Show LA, in the beginning, it just started out as our studio recital. Like at the end of the year, everyone performs. And this is when no one knew what pole dancing was. They just thought like strip club. And the very first one we ever had, like, I invited some important people from LA, some actors and things like this, and they were like, whoa, you know, this is so much different than what we thought it was. I mean, this was 12 years ago.
Oh my God.
So the first 2 years were just inside the studio, really small. But, you know, we had really famous pole dancers that were training there, like Natasha Wang and Alethea Austin, and we were performing. We did little group routines and we did some solos and, you know, we had like a little free alcohol bar and it was so fun and everybody like just looked forward to it so much every year. And then we moved locations to like a bigger location, and my studio started out next door to a big MMA gym, mixed martial arts like Muay Thai, Jiu-Jitsu together. And so we moved all to a big, big warehouse, and we divided it down the middle, like half pole dancing and half fighting. And when we were building the place, my contractor, the builder, said, oh, this wall, do you want me to make it so it opens? He's like, so it opens so that you can watch, or closes so that it can be private. And I was like, yeah, make it so it opens. So we made this big movable wall, and once a year we would move all the martial arts equipment out and put 500 seats in and have this show. And then we started inviting our friends like Janine Butterfly and Marla Fiskin and Carol Helms and these like other famous pole dancers, because we knew them from events, and we started inviting them. And then we started doing more group routines, and it just built. We started doing the show for like 500 people, and we started selling out.
Oh my God.
We started selling out in this little place, and ooh, we had some problems. Like the second year, we were like, okay, we need porta potties. Yeah. We need like bathrooms, more bathrooms, you know, because like this was a problem. Yeah. And oh, and we would like blow the electricity out of the whole building. And then we started moving on to some of the biggest venues in the United States. We've played at the Joint, or we've done the show at the Joint at the Hard Rock, which, I mean, like REM has played there. And the thing that's different about pole show is that it's all group routines and then huge stars. Now we're really working on crossing over into the mainstream, so that we are, you know, the last couple shows we've done, we've had maybe like 30, 40% not pole dancers, just people coming to see, which has been really cool.
Of the girls to bring it here to Brazil?
They just called me and were like, we want to do the, or they messaged me and said, we want to do the show. And I've had a few people, and I have a few deals working. Some people want me to bring my show there. They were like, we want to do a show with our artists, but with your advice and your help, and you know, tell us what you did and how we can make it better. And so I'm here helping them out and giving them, you know, all my experience. And we're gonna see a really cool show tomorrow night.
And what do you think about it, like doing it all over the world after that, or is just no, keep it slow?
Well, I think that, you know, the thing about this kind of a show is that you need an organizer who's gonna do a lot of work. And that's not up to me. And you know, for me to do my show, I take my people and I move them. It's very expensive, right? To move, and we do a lot of people. So if you have someone, you know, somewhere in a country, in a place that wants to organize a show like this, and they want to hire me for the same type of thing that these girls did, I mean, I think that, you know, good for them, but it's a lot of work. They take on a lot of work.
And what about you? I want to know like more about your life as a pole dancer.
Well, here's an interesting fact that you guys in Brazil might not know, but I started out as a child actor in Hollywood.
Oh.
I started in the entertainment industry as a child, which is why I'm in the entertainment industry now. I really understand what it takes to build something that's entertaining and captivating. So I worked on TV and in commercials when I was little. And I was always into gymnastics, circus, you know, diving. I did all these acrobatic sports. I was an exotic dancer when I was, you know, young, very young. And this
You're
is where
still
I learned.
Young.
I will tell you how old I am. You can keep thinking I'm young. I'm okay with that. So I worked as an exotic dancer, and then I, you know, maybe 3-4 years off, like with a regular job, and I really missed the sensual expression. And I said to everyone, God, it just like feels really good. And I heard pole dancing was kind of a new sport, and I opened a gym for other fitness activities and just put a couple poles in the back, like for me. And it, you know, I put my first video on YouTube in 2007. And it went viral, and ever since then, it's just been
getting bigger and bigger. And I think the reason that I wanted to do it is the reason everyone wants to do it. It's an amazing self-expression. And I remember telling everyone in my life, like, I think I want to do this. And everyone was like, no, don't do it. You know, everyone will know, you know. It was a very different, you know, ideology, very different mentality. And I was like, no, you know, I'm gonna do this. And I have, and you know, now everyone is extremely proud of me, my family, my friends. You know, now I travel the world, and I, you know, don't travel the world even just like a tourist, but I travel the world and I live with people, I meet different people, different cultures. And I'm having this whole, you know, new, like, experience of the world because of this sport, on top of having a business, a career, you know, lots of fans and lots of amazing experiences. And I'm super grateful for the journey and for the community that pole dancing is. I mean, that's the best part of it, you know, is the people that you meet, and we're all attracted to the same thing. So we all end up in the same place. And I love, like, seeing how people are, you know, culturally different all over the world, with different language, different food, different values, but, like, people are people. No matter where they are. And pole dancers are pole dancers, and we have something in common.
Like, same love, you know?
Yeah.
That's what connects us.
Yeah, and so I love it. And, you know, I particularly liked Brazil because it's a very fun-loving culture. It's a beautiful place, good food. I'm really happy here.
Cool. And what would you say to people who will perform tomorrow?
So, you gotta have fun on stage, you know? Nobody comes to watch pole tricks. They come to watch you live your best life on stage. So you prepare the best you can, and just remember to go out there and have fun and feel it. Feel the audience and let them see you enjoying yourself on stage. It's the most important part.
I'm so excited for tomorrow, actually. And I want to thank you so, so much for being here and participating in our channel.
Awesome.
Hopefully we will see, like, each other again and again and again so many times, because this would be like the major show in Brazil, and you would come every year to Brazil.
Hopefully I will.
Not only for Rio. She said, like, she liked Rio.
I love Rio.
Yeah, she likes so Rio best.
Well, I mean, I haven't seen anything really in Sao Paulo except for the inside of the studio, the inside of the car, the inside of the apartment. Today I went out, like, a little bit, but I've been pretty busy.
But Rio, you know, like... And that's it, guys. Thank you very much for watching this video. We have, like, thousands of other nice videos and nice people there that you can watch. Other stars, international stars, Brazilian stars. And subscribe to the channel, give your like, and thank you very much for watching this. See you soon!